As you may or may not know, with a 360-degree camera, there's no such thing as pointing the camera in the right direction. The only thing you have to be concerned about is if it's a bright, sunny day, especially with a two-lens camera, which is what I'm shooting with here. It has a front lens that shoots 190 degrees, and a back lens that shoots another 190 degrees, and they overlap to give you the 360 degrees. The only thing you have to be concerned with, like I said, if it's in bright sunlight, you don't want the sun pointing, shining directly into either one of the lenses. And you also want the subject matter to be pretty much in front of one or the other lens. It doesn't have to be directly, he or she doesn't have to be, or whatever the subject matter is, doesn't have to be directly in front of either lens. But you don't want to be, have the subject matter on the side of the camera, between the two lenses. That's the only thing that you really have to be concerned about when shooting 360. Because just by having the camera on, the person watching the video or the still image can swipe the image or the video screen itself to move around in 360 degree, and you'll be able to see, like in this situation, you can see what's in front of me, you can see what's on the side of me, and you can actually see behind me. Unfortunately, behind me, since the top is up on this Fiat Spider, you'll only see the seats, windscreen, and a small back window. That's pretty much all you get. If the top was down, which I hope I'll be able to do over the weekend, you'll be able to get a much, much better view of 360 degrees.